Hey, what's up guys? In this video, I want to show you how to reload a revolver by using reference points on the cylinder. As you can see in this cylinder right here, a fluted cylinder, there's a high spot, a flute, a high spot, a flute, okay, high spot, flute. So on every high spot, we know there's going to be a hole there, okay? The flute, there's nothing there, but every high spot, as you can see, there's a hole. This comes in handy when you need to reload this revolver in the dark. You know, normally when you take care of a threat or after you fire your weapon and you got to reload, your head and eyes have to be up and on a swivel, checking 360 while you're reloading this. Normally you shouldn't be staring down at the cylinder and looking at it, trying to reload it while something else can be going on around you. You got to be looking around behind you, 360, you know what I'm saying? So that's why I find a fluted cylinder for a defensive revolver very important, because I'll show you what I do. But you know, a lot of the Smith & Wesson Performance Centers now have unfluted cylinders, and I believe if it's going to be used for defensive work, an unfluted cylinder, you know, you lose your reference points. Okay, so as an example, HKS speed loaders are the most popular. I like them over the Safariland Comp 2s, but the SL variant is superior to all of them. But since everybody seems to have an HKS, I'll show you how I reload a revolver by using these reference points. So let's just pretend, okay, you've taken care of a threat, you need to reload this revolver, okay, you did what you got to do, bang it out. I make sure I find that reference point on the cylinder, like that. I know that this is where the charging holes are. I kind of leave my finger a little aft of that cylinder, like that. So, HKS. I index the HKS like this, just showing you, and then my finger finds that finger while I'm still looking around, you know, scanning and assessing. It drops in, and I'm done. Now, if you're going to be ever so bold where you have to reload a revolver by using one round at a time, this is where it comes in really handy, but I don't suggest you do it this way unless it's in a dire emergency. But same concept. My finger is going to be on every high spot here. So I'm going to be scanning and assessing. See how that finger finds that. Okay, move it. I'm still looking around. Anything going on? Okay. Looking around. Anything, not looking at the cylinder, I'm looking up, head, eyes up, head up. But while I'm moving the cylinder, every high spot, there's a hole. This finger here, I feel this finger, okay, I know there's a hole there, I push it in. And right here, high spot, I feel the finger, push it in. And that's basically it. I don't know guys, what do you think of that? That's just my concept. Every high spot, there's a hole. If I have to reload this revolver, by single round, I feel it, push it in, my head is still up on a swivel looking around, like that. Well, that one just went in, but there you go. So guys, leave some comments, let me know what you think, and as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.